Are you or your business the target of a defamatory online attack? In this video, I'm going to teach you how to file a defamation lawsuit so you can fight back. And we're starting right now. Hi, I'm Aaron Mink, attorney and founder of Mink Law, the nation's leading law firm for online defamation lawsuits. Getting hit with a defamatory online attack is bad news. It can negatively affect everything. What's even worse is trying to figure out what your legal rights are when it happens and how to fight back. But it doesn't have to be complex or confusing. In this video, I'm going to lay out in as simple terms as possible what the five steps are to file a defamation lawsuit so you'll know exactly what the process looks like and how to file one if you or your business has been defamed online. Before running into court and filing a lawsuit, the most important thing to do is to figure out if you have a claim. This is really important. If you don't have a valid claim, there's really no point in going any further. Defamation claims are broken down into two categories, libel and slander. Libel is defamation that is written. Slander is defamation that is verbal. When filing a claim for defamation, you must be able to prove four things. Number one, there must be a false statement of fact that concerns you. Number two, the false statement must be published or communicated to someone. Number three, the statement must have been made with at least a negligent level of intent. Negligent intent is a legal term. In defamation, it means that a person wasn't reasonably careful about making sure that what they said was truthful and accurate. And requirement four, you must be damaged. Now, these elements can sometimes vary a little depending on what state a lawsuit is filed in, so make sure to double check these things before proceeding. You can do this by visiting my firm's website at minklaw.com. We've written comprehensive state law guides with this information and more. You can find links to this content in the description below. The second step to pursuing a defamation lawsuit is assessing what defenses might apply to your claim. Just because you can prove all the elements of a claim doesn't automatically mean you're going to win your case. You have to see whether any defenses might apply that could defeat your claim. Some of the most common defenses to defamation claims are opinion, truth, absolute privilege, qualified privilege, and the statute of limitations. I'm going to explain what each of these are briefly. The defenses of opinion and substantial truth are pretty straightforward. If a statement is someone's opinion, or it's substantially truthful and accurate, it's not a legally actionable claim for defamation. Privileges apply when something is defamatory, but it isn't actionable legally because of broader interests that we consider to be more important as a society. For example, if a defamatory statement is made in a legal proceeding, it's considered protected speech under the doctrine of absolute privilege. This is because we value due process and would never want the threat of a defamation lawsuit intimidating someone from testifying in a legal proceeding, even if what they're going to testify to is false and defames the other person. The doctrine of qualified privilege applies if a false accusation is made to a very limited audience by someone when they have a legal or moral duty to communicate what they know. For example, let's say someone is reporting a crime to the police, or an employer speaks badly about a past employee to someone who calls them as a reference. As long as these people were acting in good faith and did not have actual knowledge that what they said was false, these types of situations are protected by the doctrine of qualified privilege and are not legally actionable. The statute of limitations is a rule that bars defamation claims unless they are filed within a certain amount of time from when the statements were originally made. Each state has its own limitation period. In most states, you have 1 or 2 years to file a lawsuit. However, some states you have 3 years, and in others, for slander claims, you only have 6 months. So you need to be really careful and double check what the statute of limitations is in your state before proceeding. The five defenses I just discussed are the most common. However, there are many other defenses that can be raised. The point being that figuring out what defenses may apply in your case is critical before filing a lawsuit. Once you're confident that you have a valid claim and a good idea of what defenses may come up, the third step to filing a libel lawsuit is figuring out where to file your case. This is referred to as jurisdiction and venue. In most libel lawsuits, you have the option to file your case where you live, where the person you're suing lives, where the defamation happened, or where you've been damaged. It's best to compile a list of all the places you can potentially file and consider the different factors that make a location more or less advantageous for your case. For example, which location has the most favorable laws and legal precedents? Where is it going to be the most convenient to litigate? Where are your witnesses and evidence located? Where your lawsuit is filed can literally make or break your case. It's critical to take time to figure out where the best place is to file. The fourth step to filing a defamation lawsuit is super important and is one that most people, including lawyers, often forget about. Make sure to check and see if your state has any pre-suit notice requirements and comply with those requirements if they exist. A pre-suit notice requirement is a law that requires someone filing a libel lawsuit to attempt to contact the person you're planning on suing to notify them about your pending claim. They give the person or organization you're about to sue a chance to issue a retraction or take down what they publish before you sue them. Most states don't have pre-suit notice requirements. However, a handful of states do, including Florida, Texas, Michigan, and a couple others. If you fail to comply with a pre-suit notice requirement, your case can be dismissed, abated, and certain types of damages like punitives may become unavailable. For example, Florida law requires at least 5 days notice before a defamation lawsuit is filed against someone. A notice must be sent to them spelling out your claim. Failure to comply can result in automatic dismissal of your case. As another example, in Texas, if a plaintiff fails to request a person retract defamation, a case can be abated and you can lose the ability to get punitive damages. It can be easy to forget about pre-suit notice requirements. However, it is absolutely imperative to check and see if there are any and make sure you comply if they exist. The final step to filing a defamation lawsuit is drafting and serving the complaint. All lawsuits start when a document called a complaint is filed with a court. A complaint has the following 6 components. It states the parties involved in the lawsuit, the reasons a court has jurisdiction over the case, the facts of the case, the legal causes of action that you're asserting against the other party, your demand for money or other relief, and if you want one, a request for a jury trial. Once the complaint is drafted and filed, it needs to be served on the opposing party with another paper called a summons. This is referred to as service of process. You need to formally inform the people you are suing that they're being sued. Service of process can be accomplished in a number of different ways. You can send the person copies of the summons and complaint and request they voluntarily waive service. You can serve process personally by a process server. You can sometimes do it even by certified mail. Service requirements vary greatly from court to court, so it's really important to check the rules carefully and make sure this gets done in a timely manner wherever you filed your case. I hope my explanation of how to file a lawsuit was useful. Please let me know if it was by leaving a comment below. What I discussed today was meant to be a general framework. There are lots of other things that should be looked at and considered if you are seriously thinking about filing a defamation case. At Mink Law, defamation is all we do. We spend time reviewing cases with clients and going over everything they need to know before filing a lawsuit. If you are considering filing a defamation lawsuit and are looking for help, call us for a free consult at 216-373-7706 or head over to minklaw.com and submit a contact form. This is Aaron Mink from Mink Law. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.